Aloha, everybody. Good morning. Close to afternoon. It is just about 11 o'clock. It is 10:50 right now. I'm going to wait for a few people to sign on before I give you guys the update. But the 11 a.m. update just came out on Tropical Storm Douglas. So I'm going to have the latest once a few more people can log on and I'll get started. I hope my audio is okay. On Instagram, it's weird. My front audio, the front microphone is usually all right, but the back one is all right. But I'll be switching it over just in case. So hopefully you guys can hear me well. If you have any questions during this Facebook Live, please comment them below. Jane says you can really hear me? Okay, hopefully, but if not, if you meant you can't. Okay, sound is muffled. All right, no worries. I'll flip the camera in just a sec. It looks like, all right, about 500 people are already on, so let me get right to it. Flip the camera early so that you guys can get straight to it. Is my flash on? One sec. Okay, that should be better. Okay, so this is the official track from the National Hurricane Center. Hopefully you guys can see me a bit and hear me a bit better. But this is the current position. So currently, this is 11 o'clock, and the system is still a tropical storm. So as of right now, it is forecast to continue to strengthen. Taking a look, it's forecast to continue to strengthen and become a hurricane by later today before it then weakens. So as of right now, it's looking like we're going to be seeing this strengthen to a Category 1 hurricane by later today. It's forecast to peak in the next 48 hours as a Category 2 hurricane before it then weakens back down to a Cat 1 as it enters our waters. Right now, that's that 140 mark right there. And as it does, as it starts to approach the state, it is going to be getting into some cooler waters. So good news on that front, it's forecast to weaken a little bit. Now taking a look at what we're expecting to see from this system. And again, as of right now, it is a far out forecast because the impacts wouldn't be coming through, or the system wouldn't pass directly over us until potentially late Sunday into Monday. Now, I'm going to show you, let's see, these are the forecast wind speeds for the system itself. So if the miles per hour were over 110, then that's when we get into the Category 3 hurricane. So it does strengthen to, hey Tom, could you turn off that fan real quick? Thank you. People are saying that the audio is still not good. They said, can you turn off your fan? All right, hopefully that's better, you guys. All right, so thanks, Tom. All right, so it is going to be a fairly strong Category 2 system. All right, now I wanted to show you guys the forecast model. So these are just a couple. Of course, the National Hurricane Center, when they do these systems, or when they do make their official tracks, they're looking at multiple models. So I'm just going to show you one that's accessible to the public. I'm working from home, as you guys can see, so I don't have access to all of my graphics as I do at the station, but this is going to be a good example. So this right here, and again, I told you guys about these systems at the end of last work week. We were tracking both of these, talking on air. This is Tropical Depression 7E. This system is expected to, well, it's already a post-cyclone. It's not expected to be impacting us. This system right here, though, this is Douglas. And you can see there's Mexico, so it's closer, it looks like, to Mexico than it is to us. So still very far out. And take a look at this. As it's forecast to approach the state, I'm going to play this one out. I'm going to jump ahead a few more days. Let's go, this is Thursday. And then as it starts to approach us over the weekend, this particular model, this is the ECMWF. So this is the European model. As this is approaching us, take a look. This is now Saturday and then Sunday. And this forecast model shows this passing just to the north of Hawaii Island. And I'm going to play this one out for you. As it then makes a direct pass over Maui County here on Oahu and Kauai. So, of course, that would not be a great scenario for us. Now, again, we are talking about a week out, and things likely could be changing. So stay tuned. Of course, we'll have the latest. I'm going to show you now the GFS, because this one shows a different track as well as different timing. And sorry, I know you guys are still saying my audio is not great. I know I need a new phone. I'll try to work on that. Hopefully I can fix it. Ooh, one sec. My roommate is now handing me headphones. That might help. All right, let's see.
All right, let me know if this is better, you guys. Hopefully it is. Now I'm on headphones, if you can see in my reflection. My headphones. Okay, so now, oops. All right, this particular forecast model, this is the American model, the GFS. As I play this out, the timing of this one shows it coming through a little bit later. This is the one that's closer to Monday. So right now we're at Sunday, 1 p.m. Now we're into Sunday night, early Monday morning. And this particular one shows it passing directly to the south of Hawaii Island as it then passes over us. So, of course, the actual, where this track actually goes is really going to be dictating exactly what impacts we see. But from the system, it is looking like we're looking at definitely an increase in surf, potentially very heavy rainfall, very strong winds. And if we, it's really going to depend exactly on the strength, but if we see it as of right now, it's looking like we may be dealing with direct landfall from a tropical storm, if not a tropical depression. Hopefully it does get into that wind shear. Hopefully the cooler waters really do slow down the weakening and weaken it quickly so that we won't be dealing with as strong of winds. But as of right now, potentially even coastal flooding, all of the typical impacts from a tropical system is what we could be seeing from this. So again, this is a far out forecast. We're still not talking until next Sunday into Monday. So stay tuned to KH12. We are Hawaii's weather station and we'll have the latest. But as of right now, it has yet to strengthen. I was kind of expecting at that 11 a.m. update, the National Hurricane Center, to strengthen it to a hurricane, but it looks like the sustained winds aren't strong enough just yet. For those who are tuning in a little bit late, here is a look at the forecast track. So it's forecast to strengthen to a hurricane by later today. The current sustained winds are at 65 miles an hour. So that's actually the same as the 5 a.m. So hopefully hopefully we do see this rapidly strengthen before then rapidly weakening. The earlier, the better for it to get into those cooler waters. So we'll continue to track this system, but unfortunately it is looking like that cone of uncertainty, as this extends a little bit closer, it is going to be encompassing all of the islands. And what that means is there is the potential that anywhere in this cone of uncertainty, we could see a direct landfall. So again, it's still far out, but now is the time to prepare. If you don't have your hurricane kits ready just yet, make sure you start stocking up on food and water. It's not the time to get scared or freak out, but it is the time to be prepared. And hurricane season, we're about a month and a half in now. We still have all the way through November to go. So just always have your hurricane kits and prepared and a plan in place for your family. And of course, stick with us. We'll have the latest. And the next update, Justin Cruz is going to be taking over, but I'll be back in the morning giving you the latest on Douglas as well as our local weather. It is a hot day without our trade winds, you guys. That's why I had my fan going. I don't have AC in my apartment, but on days like this, I really wish I did. All right. Aloha, everybody. Have a beautiful day. Stay safe. And again, stay tuned. Thank you for staying informed.